But because he's the God of all mercy, he has afforded us once again to come and assemble. I want you to also remember that we did not and should not be so consumed with Independence Day, because every day for us is independence. I don't have to shoot no skyrocket. I don't have to explode no M80 or no blockbuster to have a recognition that I'm independent. I'm independent because what Calvary made me free. So every day is an Independence Day. 2 Corinthians chapter number 1, verse number 3 says, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort those who are in trouble with the comfort with which we ourselves are comforted." Stopping right there, especially in this portion here where it says, "who comforts us in all our tribulation, that we may be able to comfort those who are in trouble."
Amen.
I read that again. He first comforts us in all of our tribulation, and in turn, we may comfort those who are in trouble.
Amen.
Look at your neighbor and tell them these words, neighbor.
Neighbor.
I'm built to serve.
I'm built to serve.
I'm built to serve. Look at somebody else and say, "I'm just a servant.
I'm just a servant.
I'm just a servant." Quickly and expeditiously, we want to peruse the parameters of the text to understand that Paul is giving us a clear information and understanding that God our Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, is the God and the Father of mercy and the God of all comfort.
Yes.
But I like this passage where it says, "who comforts us in all our tribulation." In other words, there is not a trouble or a problem or a situation that God does not have the ability to give us comfort in it. I don't know about you, but tribulation ain't never been comfortable. Anytime you're in trouble, it is never a comfortable situation, but to know that the Lord will comfort us in not just some of our tribulations, but all of our tribulation is good news. Hello, somebody. It's good news just knowing that no matter what I am going through, I'm not alone. Not only am I not alone, but I have the confidence to understand that he will not only comfort me, but then there is a dual responsibility that whatever I'm going through, I can look at someone else and tell them, "Hey, I've been where you've been," and I can tell you with an assuredness that God can and he will see you through. We're living in a time where people are afraid to share their experience.
Yes.
You didn't get here by yourself, nor are you to keep what God has done for you to yourself.
Yes.
There used to be a song we sang years ago, I said I wouldn't go tell nobody, but I just couldn't keep it to myself. Hello, somebody. And when God has done something for you, you ought to be able to tell somebody that God is still working miracles in my life. I just heard someone say that I'm not going to tell my testimony anymore because people look at me funny. And I told the individual, you need to tell it everywhere you go. I don't care who looks funny at you, there's somebody that needs to know that God still got power. And God still sits high and looks low. He still sits on the throne, beholding the good and evil. You ought to be able to tell somebody, "I was sinking deep in sin, far from a peaceful shore, very deeply stained He lifted me, now safe am I. Why can I say it? Because it was love that lifted me. It was love that lifted me, and love set me free. So Paul writes and tells the Corinthian church here that God is a God of all comfort. It is important, brothers and sisters, that whatever God is bringing you through, that you share it with somebody and say, yes, the tears may be falling down, and I may look like I've been in a battle, but one thing I know, the battle is not mine. It belongs to the Lord. Yes, and as long as I keep the faith, and as long as I keep trusting in Him, He is still able to deliver me out of all of my troubles. Hello, somebody. We're built to serve. We're built to serve. It's critical that we understand that we are servants. We are servants of the Lord. We are servants. We've gotten into a position that we think that we all that in a bag of chips, but the truth of the matter is all we are servants. We're servants. We're built to serve. And I stop by to tell somebody, get off your high horse and think that you're all that, because God built you to serve. Oh, yes. And I don't know about you, but I love good service. Hello, somebody. I love good service. I come along in the era when you drove your car up to the gas station and there was somebody that would run out to the car and ask you, how may I serve you? But now everything is self-serving. And maybe that's the problem. We moved away from service and everybody's expecting to do it yourself. You know, there was a song and it's still just as relevant today as it was then. Y'all remember the Isley Brothers? You remember the Isley Brothers? Some of y'all don't remember, but it's all right. You know them as Mr. Big, but I know them as the Isley Brothers. And the Isley Brothers did a song that said, "It's Your Thing." Somebody heard it too. Do what you want to do. I can't tell you who to stop it to. And that's been the problem. We've had too many "it's your thing" Christians until we've lost focus on service. Oh yeah, I love good service. And you only know how to serve when you have been made humble and don't mind serving someone else. Oh yes, there's a difference in service. Everybody now likes to go through the fast food. You like to go and drive through. Not even Starbucks, you can drive through and get your coffee. But it's so much better to me when somebody is serving you. Yeah. Some of y'all go to Denny's and you get served. You go to Denny's. I go to Denny's. Yeah. I like to Grand Slam every now and then. But it's nothing like putting a little flour, put a little water, stir it up, put a little pinch of salt, put a little pepper in there, make some gravy, and can feed a whole family. Because grandmama and big mama knew how to serve. But we're living in a modern day. Children won't even eat unless you bring it to them. You need to get off of your rusty, rickety day and get in the kitchen yourself and learn how to serve. Mama, come home from work. Why don't you wash the dishes? Mama, come home from work. Why didn't you cook something? Mama, come home from work. Why didn't you take out the trash? Mama, come home from work. You expect mama to work. You expect mama to cook. Mama to clean. Mama to buy your clothes. Mama to buy your shoes. I ain't seen a child yet worth $150 Michael Jordan. You can't jump and you ain't gonna never be like Mike. If you want your shoes, get you a job. Get you a J-O-B. A J-O-B just means just about business. And dare me to call the police. You didn't call the police on your mama. But now you want to talk about if you hit me, I'll call 911. But I got news for you. You ain't got to call 911. I got another remedy. It's called open the door and you get out. You ain't got to worry about calling the police. If you think the police is going to help you, keep on acting a fool. If you think that the police is going to be doing something better than your mama, keep on acting a fool. These children get on my nerves. They make me sick sometimes. Won't go to school. Wanna lay up in your bed, on your sheets, on your mattress, on your box spring, on your pillows, and won't even go to school. They get on my nerves. Talking about this is my room. If it's your room, when did you pay rent? This is my room. You ain't got no room. You live in free of charge, and yet you don't want to serve. You ought to be glad that somebody got a roof over your head. You come in and turn on water and waste water because you ain't paying for it. Keep all the lights on, the TV on all night long, and you don't want to serve. Shame, 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 shame on you. You ought to go to your mom and say, Mama, I'm so sorry, but I'm going to serve. You ought to tell your daddy, I'm so sorry, but I'm going to serve. We ought to tell the Lord, I'm so sorry, but I'm going to serve. For God I'll live, and for God I'll die. I was built to serve. I'm going to serve him until I die. I'm going to serve him till he cracks the sky. I'm going to serve him. I'm going to serve him.